Sawadee Kup, welcome to Thailand News Today by the Tiger, and we start off the week with news of more closings in Bangkok due to the recent COVID outbreak, potential visa amendments for digital nomads, and calls to sack the current public health minister. But before we begin, a shout out to all Tiger legends and Tiger Cubs today. We really appreciate your support as we start to wind out new products. Thank you very much to all. And now let's get on with the news. ...2,048 new COVID-19 cases and 8 related deaths have been reported by the CCSA. Now the total death toll is now at 148 since the start of the outbreak in Thailand. There are now 25,767 active cases, 20,461 in hospitals, and the other 5,306 being treated in field hospitals. 563 people are in critical condition and 150 patients are on ventilators. Out of the new cases, 901 were reported in Bangkok, 110 cases were reported in Samutprakan, which is just southeast of Bangkok. The numbers are a drop from the past 2 days, but still over the 2,000 mark for the sixth day in a row. There's now a full closure of 31 additional businesses and public services in Bangkok as from today. The full list is at thetiger.com. In other related news, the province of Surat Thani, which includes the three Gulf islands of Koh Samui, Koh Phangan, and Koh Tao, have imposed similar closures of businesses to the ones in Bangkok. The announcement says that you must do quarantine if you travel from a red zone. Residents are also being asked to stay home from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. The Thai government is considering proposals to reform the smart visa to make it easier for digital nomads to legally work from the kingdom. According to a Pattaya Mail report, the Tourism Authority of Thailand says the Board of Investments and the government's COVID-19 task force have already agreed on the details of the proposal. Digital nomads have fallen through the cracks of Thailand's immigration and tax laws for years, mostly needing creative visa agents to find ways of applying for a visa to stay in the country. Some tinkering with the smart visa category allowed some additional flexibility for potential nomads, but only in specific professions and requiring a high minimum monthly salary. The current proposal is to overhaul the visa to allow digital nomads to remain in the kingdom for up to 4 years without a work permit. Holders of the new multiple entry smart visa would also be exempt from 90-day reporting or having to obtain re-entry permits. Their family members would also be entitled to accompany them under the same flexible conditions. Foreign nationals in possession of tourist visas could transfer to the smart visa once they have proof of at least 6 months' employment and evidence of qualifications and experience. Now, the Thai government is adamant that the planned reopening of the southern island of Phuket to vaccinated foreign tourists will go ahead in July. However, with COVID-19 infections rising across the country, some tourism operators say they need more clarification on how that could possibly happen. But Thailand's Commerce Minister yesterday insisted that the Phuket sandbox model is on track for July the 1st. He said, quote, "We have neither canceled nor changed it. Currently, the province is on course to speed up its vaccination program as its inhabitants prepare to reopen and receive foreign tourists." Tourism operators in Phuket are calling on the government to clarify how this plan would work with only 2 months left to prepare. They say rules on entry requirements, travel bubbles, international flight arrangements, and vaccinations all need to be confirmed before then. Operators say it seems highly unlikely that 70% of the island will be vaccinated on time, which remains a priority if the plan is to proceed. However, the eternally optimist governor of the Tourism Authority of Thailand, Yuttasak Suphason, says officials are drawing up the standard operating procedures that will govern the sandbox model. Private parties at luxury pool villas in a Pattaya neighborhood were raided by police last night, and 28 people were arrested. Around 50 officers from the Banglamung district of Chonburi Station were called into the area after neighbors complained that parties could potentially lead to the spread of COVID-19. A birthday party for an English teacher was hosted at one of the villas, while another party was going on across the street. I didn't know English teachers throw luxury villa parties. Maybe I'm in the wrong line of work. Reports say those at the parties violated Thailand's emergency decree, which was imposed last year to help combat the spread of the coronavirus. Partygoers were not wearing masks or social distancing. Many of those arrested were foreign nationals, including 13 people from the Philippines, 6 from Russia, 2 from France, 1 from the UK, 1 from Canada, 1 from Albania, and 1 from Cambodia. The other 3 were from Thailand. Now, many of the foreigners were apparently shocked by the raid. They tried to convince the police that they aren't breaking the law because the event was private. Under the emergency order, however, all gatherings that risk the spread of COVID-19 are prohibited. The partygoers face charges of violating the Emergency Decree and Communicable Diseases Act. Police did not report on any additional charges the partygoers or hosts may face. And Thailand's health minister, Anutin Chanwirkun, is defying calls for his resignation over his handling of the COVID-19 pandemic. Members of the opposition Move Forward Party have slammed the government over how it has dealt with the third wave of COVID-19 as infections and deaths rise across the country. Critics say the current administration was not adequately prepared for a resurgence of the virus and accuse the government of negligence. The national vaccine rollout has also come in for criticism, with opposition politicians saying the procurement of an adequate amount of doses has been far too slow. In addition, patients in some parts of the country are dying at home as a result of a shortage of hospital beds. The party has insisted Anutin must resign immediately as a result. Now, for his part, Anutin has apologized for the death of an 85-year-old woman who died of COVID-19 at her home in the Bangkholam district of the capital while waiting for a hospital bed. 6 elderly people at the same shophouse complex also tested positive for the virus, and experts say unless urgent action is taken, more people could end up dying at home. It's understood that some patients are also opting to stay at home rather than seek hospital treatment, a decision that is putting other family members at risk. And that's all for the news today. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and support the Thaiger by clicking the join button to become a Thaiger legend. Thank you so much for watching, and Sawadee Krap.